in the middle. I'm almost done with this warm-up for this one. Today we got some VO2 max intervals. So I got a 20-minute warm-up and then four intervals of 3 minutes of VO2 max with a minute and a half rest in between. Slow jogging. So just like the workout from a couple days ago, but we'll see if I have anything extra in the tank today. This is a screen from the Stride app after I've loaded my Training Peaks workout into it. It tells me my power, how much time is left on this interval. It's pretty awesome. Got some music on. This is gonna hurt. Woo! That's it. Four sets. That was extremely hard. I was able to be a little bit more consistent today, I think. Now it's just a cool down all the way home.
Well, hey, welcome back. Thank you for sticking around. Thanks for watching that kind of disaster of a run. That was really hard. That was tough. Something's going on that I need to figure out, and we're going to kind of dive into it here. But first, wanted to just give Emily Heller a shout out. If you don't know who she is, check out the link below to her YouTube channel. She's doing some really awesome work. She's a self-proclaimed shoe-tuber. So she's got a lot of really good insight into running shoes. So go check her out. The run today was just very difficult to try to make happen what I needed to happen. Like, the weather was perfect. Like, there was nothing wrong. Like, it was in the 50s. I don't know. Like, I didn't, like, I felt good going into the run. I did my 20 minute warm up. And, well, let's look at Training Peaks. So here's the run real quick. You can see like all of the information, but what I wanna do is just show, I wanna hide everything else except power and then show the workout. So this is what I was going for today. This was my workout. The first 20 minutes was just a warm up, and obviously it was easy to stay in my power zone for that warm up. And then I was doing 4 3-minute intervals at VO2 max. And this light blue part up here is where I was aiming for. I was able to stay at or really close my VO2 max for that first interval, and then the second, third, and fourth one was just kind of bad. The second one was actually really close, and this isn't really that far off. Like, I was at 350 watts for about half of it, and my target was 381. 30 watts off, that's not a ton in running. I mean, it's decent. If you wanna look at my paces, like, I was at or below 6 minutes per mile for a lot of this first interval, like 557, 554. Second interval, I was hovering around 6 minutes per mile. Third and fourth interval was more like 620, 630. I was running like decently quick for me. As I'm looking back at this run and the one I had on was it Monday or Tuesday that was a VO2 max as well. I have a feeling that I'm doing these at probably a really bad time of day. I'm doing them at lunch, which, and I haven't eaten anything in probably about 5 hours. I think if probably I had maybe a gel before or sometime during this warm up, maybe these would have gone a little bit better. So I'm actually gonna try that next week when I hit my next VO2 max workout. I'm gonna have a gel either right before the run or 5 minutes into it or something so that it can kick in time for these intervals. I'm just gonna try it. I don't love taking gels on runs that are less than an hour. Like for the most part, it's not needed, but a run like this, it probably could have helped me get into that VO2 max zone, but that's all for this run. I have got several questions about why VO2 max for ultra runners. So I'm gonna go over some kind of basic stuff about running. So if you already know this, don't be offended. I'm just starting at the beginning. When we run, we use oxygen for energy, among a lot of other things. The harder you go, the more oxygen you use, but you can't just bring in an infinite amount of oxygen. And when you reach the peak amount of oxygen that your lungs can breathe in and your body can process and turn into energy, you are at your VO2 max. So the higher your VO2 max is, the larger your engine is. And that's why it's important for all runners, even ultra runners, to train this part of their system. You're pretty much born with the engine you have and there's not a whole lot you can do to increase it, but you can become more efficient when you're using it. And the more efficient you are, the longer you can sustain that type of work that you're asking your body to do. Most of us will probably never get our heart rates up high enough to even be running in that VO2 max level, like during a 100 miler, but it's still important to train that part of your system because those benefits trickle all the way down. There's obvious physical adaptations that happen from your body being able to process more lactate efficiently. Your mind will also be able to deal with the pain a lot better. And so that's kind of how I explain it to my athletes. I explain it that they're raising their ceiling for performance. When you can tolerate more work at VO2 max, you can tolerate a lot more at lactate threshold sessions. And then that means you can tolerate even more in that go all day zone two, your 100 mile pace. There's also the possibility that you might actually find yourself in a race situation where you have to, like on a really steep section or something, where you're going uphill and you really need that VO2 max to power through it. But there's also the downhills to think about. And I think a lot of people assume that going downhill is easy, and I don't really know where that comes from. Like maybe learning how to ride a bike or watching a ball roll down a hill or something, but I don't think that could be really farther from the truth for runners. You know, we can go a lot faster and maybe the amount of work is less going downhill, but your quads are really doing a lot of extra work when you're going downhill, and they're screaming by the end of a long descent because of how much work they've had to do just to stop your body from becoming that ball of rolls down the hill. So training at your high-end effort VO2 max will prepare you for those long descents too. And if you don't have a place to train properly, like you don't have a steep enough hill or something, that'll really help a lot doing some of these VO2 max intervals. All right, so that's it. I hope I was able to clear up some of the questions. If you don't remember anything from what I just said, remember the analogy of raising the ceiling. When you raise the ceiling, all work at lower levels also becomes easier for your body to do. So there you go. And that's like super basic, but it is based on science. There's a lot of books that you can go read about it. If you have questions about what books to read, like just ask. Like I'd be happy to share some of my favorite ones with you. All right, that's it for this one. I hope you guys are staying safe, staying healthy, and getting out to run. I will see you again soon. Bye.